Today I'm going to working with incident management application lifecycle and state model. First of all, you would like to know what is an incident, guys. Guys, anybody idea about that incident? What is incident basically? I'm asking general question. What is the incident?
Ajay here. Incident nothing but it's just like something has got broken at particular time.
Or something is broken in any particular business application, right?
Yes.
Okay. So anybody reminding us, anybody idea about incident? So daily we are going to work with incident. We are calling so many times, right? So first of all, what is the incident, right? See, incident is a very important and a major application in the ServiceNow platform in every business unit maybe, right? So what is the incident? Incident is nothing but simply I can say something unexpected interaction, right? So incident is nothing but unexpected interruptions. So any customer unfortunately facing the problem in their business application, then they consider as one incident, right? So incident simply we can call to so many things, so many definitions in that, right? So but simply I can say incident is something is broken into your application or unexpected interruption, not expected, right? Sometimes we can call it as a accidentally happened, not expected, right? Suppose I can say, so where we can consider that incident, suppose I can say example, I'm the person. Okay, so I'm working in one organization. I'm trying to connecting my office network through VPN. So when I'm trying to connecting through VPN, unfortunately unable to connect. So that is we can consider as an incident. And already we discussed one more scenario, right? So in the basic time, what we discussed, so one person trying to get bank statement for last 6 months, so that time unable to get it, that is a called incident. So where unfortunately customer facing the problem, that is called incident, unexpected interruptions, not expected, right? That maybe accidentally any happened in the business application, so that time we can consider as a one incident record. So first of all, we navigated to incident record. So now we are going to working with lifecycle and state model. First click on that to create new, right? Now I'm going to explain that one by one. So incident lifecycle and management application, incident lifecycle and state model, that is not included in my book, right? Just I'm going to explain in the purpose of the each field, how these are going to working in internally. Okay. So this is an incident application form header, right? So what about that attachment icon? Use it to attach the any particular customer issue. That may be any file can be able to attach the customer issue, that energy attachment, right? So already we seen that how to creating process flow formatter and a replace of that we can be able to use and create annotation as well. And now I'm going to working with that one by one each field. What about the number field, guys? That number field is going to generating automatically. It's a one-time activity, right? So where we are configured in the table level. So in the table may contain three tabs. In that middle one tab called control tab. There we have one property is auto number. Enable the property. So when you create any record through the table, now what is the prefix has to be taken, and the number will be stored with each number, and totally it has to be taking the 7 or 6 digit number, right? So the number is generating automatically from the table. Already we seen that, right? And what about the color? So who actually facing the problem? So some clients, they're going to follow that customer or affected user, caller, customer, affected user, all of the same, right? Caller nothing but who actually facing the problem on your business application. The person should be present in color field. So why? Because sometimes, so behalf of the customer, some ITL users, other people is going to create in the record, right? But always who actually facing the problem, the right person can existing in color field, right? And what is the category? So the problem is related to which category? The problem is related to hardware category, and software category, right? Now I'm going to add the choices just to try to understand something here, right? So in the category field, right? See, in that category, we have a different categories that are available: inquiry and software, hardware, network, database, right? So these are all categories already configured by ServiceNow administrator. Based on the client requirement, our client requirement, we need to configure the different choices as well in category field, right? So, but we need to understand the dependent value. So in the category is that inquiry, if you select an inquiry in the category, displaying that related or related subcategories. In case if you select the network, displaying that subcategory of network. If you select that hardware, displaying that hardware related subcategories. Same like that, if you select that in HR, displaying that no subcategories are associated to your category, right? No, I'm trying to say that how to creating new choices as per the client requirement. Very simple, right? So right click on that category, right click on that any field. So you form a container, so many choice field, right? How to create a new choices to that choice field. Right click on that field and go to that config choices. Very simple process to create in the choices. Multiple ways we have, but these are best practice to creating the choices into existing field. So I need to creating that finance department. Finance, right? So that issue may be related to finance, and save it. Successfully, I have added one more choices to my category field. Now finance choice also there. Now hardware, display that hardware related subcategories. Selected software, displaying that software related subcategories. Same like that finance, but there is no subcategories are associated to category, right? So now I'm going to creating some subcategories into finance category. How can you configure it? First of all, we need to select the category where you want to create in the subcategories. So this time I'm going to select in the finance category. In that I'm going to create in the three subcategories. So finance I have selected already, and I right click on the subcategory and configure choices. Previously there is no subcategories into that category field, right? Category field. So now I'm going to finance. Save it, right? So number is generating automatically, right? In case of if you click on that create new, right? So 137 and 138, 139. If you are not created any record also, the number is generating automatically. So that is will be defining, it's a unique record of the number, unique person. Suppose I can say example, when any customer created any incident record, it may be like a reference of that person record, right? And the color can be defined who actually facing the problem. And category is the hardware, displaying that hardware related subcategories. If you select the finance, displaying that finance related subcategories. But my question is, how the subcategory values going to display based on the category? How the subcategory values going to display based on the subcategories, based on the category? Background, we are configured one dependent value. Subcategory values displaying based on that category value. So right click on the subcategory, configure dictionary. Background, they're configured. If you open that subcategory dictionary entry, this is a subcategory field, right? Subcategory field. So in that we have one tab is called dependent field. So the subcategory field is depend on category field. Background, we are configured where dependent is a one tab in dictionary record in that. So we have to configure the dependent value of category. Guys, clear?
Yes,
this is
sir.
A very, very important dependent value, how they're configured, I'm going to explain. Okay, so same scenario can be applied to assignment group and assigned to also. The category based on that category, hardware, display that subcategory. Suppose I can say, in your case, you can implement the new one also, that is called, so you can set that country that might be US, that might be like Australia, that might be in other countries as well, India, Canada, like any, right? So in that I need to display the different cities. So when you set that India, display the India cities. When you set the US, display the US cities. When you set the Canada, right? Dependent values, nothing apart from that, right? And the same like that, assign to and assignment group also working based on dependent. See, and when you select it, network. Okay, and the same like that, display that only network people in that particular table, particular group. Same like that, if you're selecting any other group, if you select any other group, that might be hardware, displaying the hardware members who are included in particular hardware group. So this assigned to field is displays based on that assignment group where we're configured. Go to assign to dictionary entry. There also we have one more dependent field. We are configured that assignment group. In case if you remove this one, what happened? Other group. So now check it out. In case if you remove that any dependent value from here, right, dependent value. So just if you remove the dependent value of category, assignment to save it. Just I'm going to show that how it will be working with dependent value, without dependent value. Right. So now go to that new form. And if you select any group, system cannot understand that there is no dependent. Very simple to configure the dependent value without writing a single line of code. If you select the database, it has to be display only database group members, but it will display in the all the members in that include the table, right? Why? Because background we have removed that dependent value. So assigned to value is displaying that based on that assignment group. So how can you know this assignment group internal name? You have to pass in that background. Assignment group assigned to configure dictionary. Right, and scroll down. So the dependent, where is the dependent value? Dependent value, we have to fill that dependent field is there. In case if it is not there, we can add that dependent field to your form, dictionary entry form, then update it. Now it will be working fine. Check it out. If you select any particular group, that may select hardware, display that only members included in particular software group. Understand, guys? So this subcategory and category assigned to assignment group, these four fields work together, like working as the same based on the dependent value. Clear, guys? Clear this point? How to configure the dependent value? How these are going to display automatically? So I'm giving that one assignment to you guys. So in your case, you can create two fields. One is that country field, second one is the city field, right? So if you set that country called India, display that India cities. If you set that to Canada, display the Canada cities. Like that, you can configure some choices into that both fields and configure the dependent value in that. Can you do that requirement, guys? Can you do the task?
Yes, we'll do.
Remaining, I'm expecting that response from remaining guys also. Abhishek.
Yes, sir.
And I need to understand, right, what you are understanding and how much level you are going to reach it my syllabus, right? Now, okay. So this is about that assignment group and assign to and category subcategory going to work together like a dependent value. So configuration item and closure, configuration item and business service we can discuss later, not required right now. And what is the contact type? Contact type is one field. So when that contact type is used to like how the customer is contact to customer care, like directly call that phone through phone, and they that the person might be drop a mail to that customer care, or a create instant record through self-service application, or directly walk in, nothing but directly come to that office and given the complaint. So what is the contact process, contact way to the customer care, right? So this contact type can be defining how the customer is contact to customer care or LPS department. Now we can discuss later about that. Different states are available in my state model when we work with the state model, and at that time we can explore more into that. Now I'm going to work with the remaining. See, if you're working on that remaining things, just to try to understanding what is happening here. So one day, what is that? If you select it high and urgency also high, what happened? In case if you select that medium and medium moderate, if you select high and medium urgency high, what happening guys here? See, when you selecting impact and urgency based on that these two fields, third value is going to calculating automatically. So if you select that impact is high and urgency high, we can discuss later what does that mean by impact and what is the observation of urgency. That is different concept, right? But first of all, you would like to know why these are going to calculating automatically, where we are configured. That should be, you know, right? See, when you select that high impact and urgency also high, that priority is going to calculating critical. So where we are configured, I'm not going to select the priority value manually. This value is going to calculating automatically based on that impact and urgency. If the impact is medium and urgency also medium, what happened? Moderate. In case if impact is high, urgency is low, what happened? It's a moderate. How these three fields are going to calculating automatically? Impact and urgency priority is these three are common fields for every application, sorry, every incident table in that every organization, every project. It's a common, right? And just we need to know where they're configured, nothing but data lookup rules. This priority value is going to calculating data lookup rule, through data lookup rule, where they're configured, background, they're configured, which table, DL underscore, U underscore, priority, dot list. I'm going to open the records. So if you're confusing this one, I can open it directly here. So DL underscore U underscore priority dot list. So background, they're configured, which table, this table, right? Data lookup table. So when you selecting impact high, urgency high, critical one. When you select any customer selected, impact is high, urgency medium, priority should be high. And when any customer selected, impact is medium, urgency high, then the priority should be high, right? So we have configured that background lookup definition or lookup rules. So automatically calculated in the priority frame, right? So now I'm going to calculate my one.
Sir, what is this number?
Which one?
This 100, 200, 300.
So one nothing but order, right? One is nothing but an order number. So system order number is a common for that. It's a common field for that every application. Nothing but if you're trying to create in so many fields in that, right? So previously when we create in that, what is that? Boxes, right? Process flow formatter. So that time we have passed at 100, 200, 300 like that, right? Why? Because new is the first 100, first box, in progress is the second box, 200, on hold is the third box, 300, like that, right? Just here going to be different order wise. First record order number, second record order number. There is no specification for that. Okay. So now,
sir, what is this table name?
Sorry?
This table name.
DL underscore type. U underscore priority. So you can follow my video, right? That time may be better for you, right? DL underscore U underscore priority. DL underscore U underscore priority. In the table, they have configured this data lookup rules. But my requirement is, so navigate it to incident. Just click on that create new. My requirement is, when any customer selected very, very high impact, urgency also very, very high, then priority should be very, very critical. How can you configure this lookup rule in my predefined table? Already they configured that predefined lookup rule, right? But now I'm going to customizing. I need to add one more lookup rule to my table. First of all, what we can do, if you want to select that one more choice to, if it is not available by default, right? First of all, what we have to do, we need to create a choice, right? How to create a choice? Guys, tell me that, how to create the choice? Tell me the procedure. Right click on that impact and config choices. And that same order we have to follow, same process, same order, same standards we have to follow. Very, very high. This game and agency also config choices. They said when your impact is at very, very high, urgency also very, very high. So why the priority is not going to calculating, as I think we have to add one more choice to my priority field also. That purpose also I can creating one more choice to my priority field. Seven, eight, very, very critical. Yes, successfully I have added different choice to different field, right? When you selecting at a high and agency also why priority will be critical one. Background we are configured. But when you set that very high and agency also very high, where is the priority? It's not going to calculating. Guys, anybody observed why it's not going to calculating? Anybody observe? Why it's not going to calculating?
Maybe it is not dependent on that particular field.
It's not dependent. Just have a credit choices to my fields, right? Impact and adjust priority. Background,
we have not given rule.
Yes, we have to get the rule record, right? So the table, navigate the table, DL underscore, U underscore, priority. It's a predefined table. It was created by the company by default itself, right? So DL underscore, U underscore, priority. Dot list DL underscore U underscore priority table. I'm going to open a table. So these are all records already configured. Now system is going to understand that. So now I need to create one more data lookup rule. When customer selected very, very high impact, urgency also very, very high, then priority should be very, very critical. This is the 11th record. I'm going to pass in the 1100. So this is nothing but a customization, guys. Clear, right? You successfully configure that lookup rule also. Again, navigate into incident table and click on the create new. Create new. Impact is very, very high. Urgency also very, very high. Priority is very, very critical. So these are the way we have to configure it. This is the way we have to configure that lookup rules. And so based on that impact and urgency, priority should be calculating automatically. Why? Because we will discuss later what is impact and urgency. And one more thing also, so background, they are configured one more lookup rules. That is called lookup definition. And go to that system policy and data lookup definition. So open that data lookup definition. System, how they it can be understand that, what is the setter field, what is it major field. So based on that impact agency, impact and agency as a matcher fields, based on that this field matching, okay, and priority deadlock approval we have config, right, based on that impact agency. So based on that impact and agency in the matcher fields, so we can set the value into setter field called priority, right? So background that priority deadlock approval definition is there. So you can check that these two records, two values in that, and matcher fields are that impact agency, setter field into that priority. We are configured into data lookup definition. Clear, guys? Clear everything? And so go to that paint. I can diagram. See here how many tables are going to work in? Four tables. One is that incident table. Incident table is a source table, right? A customer is going to select the impact and agency from which table? Incident table. So based on that incident table, here what happened? So that we'll be checking that lookup rule, right? See, source table is incident, and lookup rule table is DL underscore U underscore priority. Then, so one more table is called lookup definition, right? So based on these three values, the lookup rules are going to work. What is that? Lookup. Lookup definition. Clear, guys? This is about data lookup rule. Clear? Incident table again. Navigate incident table. Guys, it's clear. So a customer is going to select in that impact is high, agency also high. It is a priority will be critical one. So source table is that incident table, and lookup rules are going to calculate from where DL underscore U underscore priority. It's a predefined table. There they have configured lookup rules, and where we have set the matcher field and setter field. So impact and agency are the matcher fields. Set the value into lookup field, right? Look like a priority field. That is called setter field. So four table or three tables are going to work together, and finally perform that like lookup rules in ServiceNow incident table. Here, guys. Now I'm going to talk about what is the mean by the impact and what is agency. First of all, so I'm going to create an incident record. If that incident record is at something here, Roy Sorok, right? See, it is a problem is VPN. What happened, guys? Here, category, and obviously the problem, who is facing the problem? Roy, right? So Ray is that caller is facing the problem, and so what is the impact? If that the caller is VIP, if the caller is VIP customer to my business unit, if really this caller is the VIP customer to my business unit, that my impact is always high level, right? So that's why we are given that impact is always high, and customer is obviously they're looking for that object, obviously high rate, and based on that high and high critical. In case of if the customer is VIP, Rai is nothing but is Rai customer is at VIP to my business unit, so it may impact on the business. That's why we need to give that priorities of high. So priority we are not going to start taking directly, right? So it may impact on the business is high level impact on the business, right? Because this is the person VIP customer to my business, right? That's why we need to provide in the priority one. So when the ticket is priority one, so the respective developer has to provide services to within 1 hour. So how can you calculate that one? Background there we are going to run into one more SLA definition, that is called SLA timeline, right? So we can discuss later when we work at the SLA. Just I'm going to explain what is that impact and what is urgency. Impact is nothing but if the customer is VIP, it may impact on the business. It will be calculated the how much percentage impact on the business, how much percentage like urgency to the customer. So finally, this based on these two fields, priority will be calculated. And in case if you click on that priority link, it will open the product documentation. There you can be able to understand the more things into that priority lookup rules. Right. sorry, in that lookup rules, ID uses three metrics for determining the order of each incident processes. See the effect of the task cause and business, and the extent to which task resolution can be delayed. Nothing but how the customer is looking for the urgency base, and finally, we need to configure that whole priority base. How quickly the service desk should be address the task. That may be priority 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? One nothing but the respective developer have to close the service to within 1 hour. Two, right, nothing but 8 hours they have to close the ticket. And three, moderate, they have to close the ticket within 24 hours. So based on that impact emergency, priority will be calculating. Finally, priority will be marked as quickly service the quickly to service the customers. Right, guys, this is nothing but a priority lookup information. How they're configured, background they're configured, right? So by default, the priority field is read only and must be set by the selecting impact agency values. Already we've seen that very configured. Next one is, so incident. This is incident lookup rule. What about the problem table also? We have a different lookup rules. Same lookup rule table not working on the both table, right? Same lookup rule table not working for both incident and problem. So impact and agency priority is available on that problem table also. When you select that very high and agency is very critical. So, but this problem record is different. Where is my very high rate? This table lookup rule is different completely. So how can you configure this again? So this is a task for you, right? So how can you configure it? So in your case, you can create one more choice like a very, very high. Urgency also very, very high. Priority should be very, very critical. And go to that. That is important. In which table you have to configure it? That is called the DL underscore. DL underscore. Lookup underscore problem. I think it's not correct name. It's not a correct table, I think, right? So DL underscore problem underscore lookup. I think this is the correct table. No, right? See. How can you know that DL underscore problem underscore priority? This is the priority lookup table for problem table. Problem table lookup table different. Incident table lookup table is lookup rule different table, right? See DL underscore problem underscore list. So in the table, you have to configure one more record. See, we have the present record, right? Very high. You can create that same kind of like operation you can implement in problem table. Already we've seen that incident table, right? Clear, guys? Clear? In that same kind of lookup rules, we can implement scope application also. Don't want to apply the predefined tables. Like, let's say example. So when the customer, when that employee designation is manager, and then title is that the employee designation is that IT department, employee department is IT, sorry. Employee department is IT. We can create in three fields: employee department, employee title, and like a hotel. So when that employment department is IT and the title is the manager, reporting manager, so automatically we can book the 5-star hotel. When employment department is finance and employee department is like a department is finance or HR, and the title is that executive HR, we can assign that we can book that only 4-star hotel, right? This kind of lookup rule you can build in scope application. How can you build it? Guess it, try it, and then we can discuss. So you can try it, guys, how to implement this kind of lookup rule in scope application, not a predefined application. Scope nothing but a custom application. So when we're working with that scope application, that time we can explore more into that, like we can work with the lookup rule also. Right, these three fields are work together in incident management application. Clear, guys? Any doubt in the lookup rule? Afreen, Abhishek, Ajay, Madan, Nazir, Pavan, Sajid, any doubts in lookup rule table? No doubt, right? Maybe you can't hear my voice. Okay, no. So, guys, any doubt? Shall I move to next one?
Okay.
It's clear, right? Next one is. Next one. Okay. So, next one is I'm going to explain the fields incident, right? What about the next one, guys? See, number is generating automatically. Already we explained. Already you know that where it is generating automatically. Color can be defining who is the problem facing that. So who is that associated user to problem facing, and the problem is related to which category, and on which configuration item, nothing but a service application. How the customer is contact to customer like customer care or address department. What the current state of the record? We will discuss later about that state of the record. And what is the impact on agency? Based on that impact on agency, priority will be calculating. And so what is the assignment group? Which group is going to working on the ticket? Which person is going to working on the ticket? We can be able to get all the details in that. One second, guys. All right, guys. Next one is a short description. What is a short description? The short description can be defining customer issue. A customer always they have to provide in the customer issue in that short description field only, right? So now I'm going to pass in that VPN. So when you pass any keyword in that particular short description field, automatically display some related articles to your issue, right? So how these are going to display automatically? So what is this one, guys? Now I'm asking some questions. Why? Because already I explained about this particular format, right? What is the formatter name? What is formatter name, guys?
Contextual for.
Yeah. So contextual search result formatter. So what is the purpose of this formatter? Nothing but it is going to be capture the some value from the short description. Already we seen that where we are configured, the contextual search application is there, background we are configured that. So this contextual search result formatter is going to capture only short description value. Then what happen, where that records are matched, where the articles are matched to your issue, displaying automatically. So what happened here, customer point of view, the customer can following the related knowledge articles, a customer point of view, they can follow the related articles, knowledge articles, and really they can check with that articles following the step by step. If really fulfill the requirement, they no need to creating any incident record in my incident table. Why? Because so instead of creating the incident record, they can fulfill the requirement following the knowledge articles. So automatically what happened, guys, the time can be saved to customer and LBS department because of no need to coordinating the people. And finally, sorry, that time can be saved to development team people as well. Why? Because so everybody don't need to working on a particular incident record. If the customer created the incident record, they have to provide in the service to the customers to yield value, right? See, this is the importance of that short description. So this is nothing but a contextual search result. It is going to be capture the short description value, the customer issue, displaying that related articles. This article is already created in my knowledge management table, tp_knowledge. We can discuss later when we working with that knowledge management application. That is a different concept, different application. Clear, guys? So how to configure the VPN, already display, right? And this is about contextual search result and description. So any customer they want to provide in a short description about your issue, we have to providing in short description. Anybody they want to define in the detailed description about your issue they have to provide it in description field. So what about anybody any customer they want to add the attachment? Why? Because sometimes a developers or responsible person unable to working on the ticket or issue, that time this customer have to providing screenshot, right, about that your issue, right? So they can be able to add the attachment about your issue and choose a file here. Clear guys, this is about
sir, do we have any option to remove this attachment file?
Yes, suppose any customer, suppose I can say a customer is trying to add the attachment, choose file, right? I'm going to add that any attachment that might be, any attachment, small attachment, I can add it here, open. Yes, I'm going to add the attachment to my incident record. A customer point of view, every customer, they can add the attachment like this. But in case if you want to remove any attachment that might be impact on that any performance, yes, that time you can be able to, like, so if you want to download the attachment, yes, click on the download attachment. And if you want to rename the attachment, yes, directly we can be able to rename the attachment. Or else if you open that particular link, right, see if you open that any particular attachment here, download it. And in case if you want to open the attachment link, so how can you remove it? So select it and remove the button enabled, right? So if you want to remove this attachment, click on that enable checkbox. Yes, successfully remove the attachment from the record. Clear, Nazir?
There is, sir.
Next one is come down. We have a different sections are available in my incident management application. So what is the notes and what is the watch list? What is the work notes list? Anybody idea, guys? Anybody idea? What about the work notes? What about that work note watch list? Anybody idea what is the watch list? What is the work notes list?
I believe watch list is the there we can give the users details who can able to access this particular incident.
Not access, actually it's not right word of access. So it is going to like watch the record of that current activities. Suppose I can say yes. Example. Right. Suppose I can say example, you are my customer. Ajay is one customer of my business unit. He's a VAP customer, right? Srinivas is that head of that business unit. So Ajay is that VAP customer. Srinivas is that head of department, like head of the business unit. So when Ajay created a ticket in my incident table, always I need to track that status of the record continuously. So anybody they want to track that record of the status continuously, a person can add it in watch list automatically. Why? Because so Ajay is a VIP customer to my business unit because as a business unit head, that is my responsibility to track the activities of the record. What happened here? Any customer update the record of this, any customer when update the record automatically send a notification to the member who is included in the watch list, right? So that's why we can add the watch list. Clear?
Got it.
Next one is, what about the work notes list? What is the difference between work notes list? This work notes list content can be displayed to only internal team. I can say example, I'm the Srinivas, right? So I'm the team lead of your team. I'm the team lead of your all team. You are seven members are the team members in my team, and I'm the team lead with the team members. So any team member working on that particular ticket, always that is my responsibility to track the what is going to happen what is the conversation going to happen between the people, right? So when you update anybody, update the record in the documents field, automatically send the some notification to the person who is included in my work notes list. That is called work notes. But external comment is different, work notes different. External comment information can send that information to the customer, and work notes will send the information to that internal team. So to what is going to happen and how our team member is going to provide a service to the customer, what is the conversation happening between the customer and the team member.
Sir, can you tell this watch list again?
Which one?
Watch list.
Watch list. Suppose you can enter a concept in and this, what is the purpose of the watch list field? You could end and suppose who created the record. In case of, suppose I can say example, a customer is here, Narendra Modi. Narendra Modi is the one customer to my business unit. When Narendra Modi created an incident record, right? So he is very important customer to my business unit. ఎప్పుడైతే నరేంద్ర మోడీ టికెట్ క్రియేట్ చేస్తామో ఎవ్రీ టైం, అంటే ఇప్పుడు నరేంద్ర మోడీ, వెన్ నరేంద్ర మోడీ క్రియేట్ టికెట్ దట్ టైం సంబడి దే వాంట్ టు వాచ్ ద రికార్డ్ బికాస్ సో నరేంద్ర మోడీ ఈజ్ అ విఐపి కస్టమర్ దట్స్ వై సమ్ బిజినెస్ యూనిట్ పీపుల్ సో డైరెక్ట్లీ ఇన్వాల్వ్ ఇన్ టు ట్రాక్ ద రికార్డ్ స్టేటస్ సో హియర్ ఈస్ అ సర్వీస్ నో సిస్టమ్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటర్ ఈస్ ద రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ నాట్ సిస్టమ్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటర్ ఎనీ అదర్ పీపుల్ కెన్ సెలెక్ట్ ఇట్ నౌ దిస్ టైమ్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు సెలెక్టింగ్ ఎనీ అదర్ పీపుల్ right so is the Katina is the person I'm going to remove this one Katina is the person to watch the record status what happened here if you update any value in this particular record that was created by the Narendra Modi automatically send the notification to this person so this person can be able to get the information so this is happening in this particular record nothing but track the record itself within platform who is watching that Katina Ramar nothing but a live status right
who can give multiple names right
yes yes you can be able to add the multiple name also yes multiple people they want to track the ticket track the what is the track the ticket means nothing but they don't want to track the record manually don't want to open the record manually what happened who is the person included in the watch list field automatically the send the notification when you update the record right so when anybody update the record automatically send a notification to the watch list people and I'm going to add the one more people also yes we can be able to add the multiple people there is no limitation
okay I have one query here sir as you said so suppose if someone has added in the watch list so is that guy will be able to open the incident or only he will get the notification
only get the notification he don't have any rights to open the record update the record delete the record nothing else only watch the record okay. Nothing but suppose I can say example so some ex person nothing but the responsible person is going to update the record nothing but impact high urgency high and what happened priority right save it and while submit that we have to fill the mandatory field right next concept is UI policy that time you can explore more into that UI policies hardware and here also save the record stay on the same form just to have updated the record right see what happened here something you have updated okay that is nothing but activity what happened so system administrator is updated the record what is updated the record impact is high and priorities so impact is in the impact value high and priority will be critical one right and I'm going to capture we will discuss later more into that which one like implementation concept okay here going to track the which fields only high end priority there is no like impact and priority there is no urgency right that's why urgency is not calculated here we will discuss later this one okay now what happened so when you update the record automatically the notification will be sent to these two person also because somebody update the record somebody yes so these are the responsible yes this somebody is going to working on the ticket they are happy right nothing but tracking the live status only watch the record what is going to happen what is the activity is going to happen nothing apart from that okay
sir then what will be the difference between for both watch list and work notes list the same is happening at both
watch list nothing but somebody they want to, some experts and outside people, they want to track the records, nothing but there is no they're not going to creating updating something else, right? Only watching the records. If you update the record, automatic send notification. They want to watch it only. But workmanship nothing but here. If you update that, any something into that, please look into this issue, right? So when you work notes, when you update the something in work notes, right? So somebody watch that, right? Work notes value. So who one watch that work notes value? Team lead and senior resource, right? Suppose I can say some junior resource working on the ticket. So just I want to know how the junior resource is communicating to the customer. As a team lead, I want to track it, right? That time, every time the customer can updating that something in that work notes, right? That will be displayed to send the notification to this work notes like field, this person work notes list. Right? Now what happened?
Yeah.
This can be displayed to only internal teams, internal purpose, not visible to customer point of view. Customer cannot see that work notes field. Just a second. Don't worry about work notes and watch list. So once again, when we're working with that scope application, that time I will show that how we can create in the same fields watch list and work notes and these are all the fields, additional comment field also, how we can creating, how these are going to working in my platform. Okay, so just I'm going to explaining how these are fields are going to working. So the notes section is the common for all application. It is going to be maintaining that watch list, work notes list, and maintain the activities. So what happening here? Automatically move the cursor. Guys, so something is like my cursor is not working properly. Might be it's a system issue. Okay, guys, remaining we can discuss tomorrow, guys. Any doubt today itself, today's session?
Sir, this is Pawan.
Pawan, please.
Sir, let's say there are three incidents which needs to be watchlist upon. So based on which information are we going to track it? How we can relate, like this is related to incident one, incident two, incident three. Do we have any field to easily identify when we are watch listing?
Not getting your question.
There are three incidents, sir.
Three incident records. Okay, fine.
Yeah, three incident records. I've been asked to watch list on them.
Okay, you so want to add that watch list?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
All the three incidents, I want to add it to watch list.
Okay.
Now, based on which information I'm going to identify, like it is related to incident
Yes,
one.
that's a really good question. Actually, background we have to configure it. So what are the information we need to track in that update of record, right? See, I don't want to track the all the record updation. Okay, I want to track the only limited field updation, right?
Yes,
so
in sir.
That, so my activity field, right? We have two types of activities. One that actually work notes and external comment field is data type is like, what is that? Input and list, right? General input, general list. We have three types of fields, right? So what is the behavior of that one? Those are the components, not going to store any data. When you enter the data in external comments and work notes, automatically display the under the field, right? See, what is that purpose? So which data you want to capture in that activities, right? So we need to configure separately. I will show you tomorrow, Pawan, that one.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So something is wrong here. Okay, guys, so see tomorrow. Nice day. Bye-bye.
Can you upload the yesterday's videos?
Yeah, today. Now upload. I will upload now. Okay, yesterday and today.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Good night.
Okay, good night.